Hello everyone, it's Fu here, and today I want to talk to you about Healing Wish, which is a super interesting move that I think is really underrated, and actually it received a buff in Sword and Shield, which is why I want to talk about it today. So what Healing Wish does is it sacrifices the user and they faint, so that the next Pokemon that you bring in gets a full heal, all of its HP restored, as well as any statuses healed too. Now, in Sword and Shield, this mechanic was slightly changed because it allowed you to store up Healing Wishes, which is a really interesting change that they decided to implement. What this means is if you use Healing Wish and then bring in a fully healthy Pokemon, Healing Wish won't activate straight away. It's kind of stored in the ether somewhere. And then when you do bring in a damaged Pokemon, that Pokemon will be healed straight away. So you can see here, Rillaboom comes in, it's already received some damage and it gets healed. And this is great for just keeping momentum or keeping the Healing Wish there for when you need it in singles battles, but its real potential is seen in doubles battles. So I want to show you a battle I had that kind of shows off some of the ways you can play around with it there. So in this battle, my opponent leads with their Hail combo, Alolan Ninetales and Kyurem, and I lead with Lopunny and Solgaleo, which is a pretty good lead on my part because the Steel matches up well against the two Ice types. I think that maybe they thought I'd bring my Kyurem and try out for some Weather Wars there, but this works out pretty well for me. My only concern is whether Kyurem is Choice Scarf, because then a double Blizzard combo might take out my Lopunny, which would be a bit concerning, and that actually does turn out to be the case, that Kyurem is Choice Scarf. However, the Ninetales goes for an Aurora Veil instead. Looking at the damage, Lopunny might have survived the Blizzard there though, but Aurora Veil is fine for me because it allows my Lopunny to get the Brutal Swing off, which will break any Focus Sashes on my opponent's side of the field, and it also activates my Solgaleo's Weakness Policy, so that I can basically just ignore that Aurora Veil. I'm going to do so much damage with my Steel-type moves, and I can go for Max Steel Spike into the Kyurem and actually take it out, which is fantastic. That's a really good news for me because the Choice Scarf is gone. It might mean that my Lopunny gets an attack off next turn. We'll have to see. But that's good. That's definitely not the battle over. The opponent has another restricted, which was Palkia, which we see come in now, and that's going to be much harder to take down, especially with the Aurora Veil up, and they do decide to Dynamax it. So I'm hoping that my Lopunny can get one more attack off. The Ninetales goes for a Blizzard, and I am able to survive on 7 HP. So that's amazing EVing there, just able to survive, and I get the Healing Wish off. Now, I don't have any damaged Pokemon in the back, so I'm aiming to store up that Healing Wish in the Lopunny slot. I go for a Max Quake here. I know that it won't do too much damage because it doesn't have same type attack bonus and they've got the Aurora Veil, but I am at +2 attack, and even with that +2 attack, I was quite disappointed with that damage into Palkia, so it's probably a bulky Palkia. But getting the special defense boost is what's really important here. It means that I can take this return Max Quake a little bit better, although it still does a ton of damage. So that's not looking too good. Solgaleo has already taken a lot of damage, and yeah, I've only got one more turn of Dynamax. They've got two. I've got some more hail buffeting, which isn't great. But now I can bring in my Togekiss, which has the ally switch, and this is the really interesting interaction with Healing Wish, because I've just brought a damaged Pokemon into the slot which had the Healing Wish pending, and now my Solgaleo gets a full heal, which is basically a whole Solgaleo's HP bar, considering that I'm Dynamaxed, and that's massive. Now I can go for another Max Quake, and now I've got a full HP Solgaleo, which will have two special defense boosts and a defense boost, being super, super bulky. And what's really nice is that I was able to use the controversial ally switch, which my opponent tried to play around. They tried to play around the follow me on the Togekiss and targeted a Max Rockfall into the Togekiss slot, but now it's a Solgaleo, which has +2 special defense and resists, so I take like no damage, and my Togekiss is kind of still sitting on the field. So that worked out super, super well. I couldn't have asked for it to go better. Now my opponent still has one turn of Dynamax. I'm not in the clear just yet. The opponent goes for Blizzard, and outside of the hail, they do actually miss on my Solgaleo, but it would have done negligible damage anyway because I've got +2 defense and I resist. Thanks to the special defense boost on my Togekiss, that actually also survives, so nice EVing there as well. I'm able to take out the Alolan Ninetales with my +2 attack, despite the Aurora Veil, which is great. And the Palkia goes for a risky Max Quake here, because I could have gone for another ally switch or a follow me, but they do predict correctly and get some damage onto my Solgaleo. But thanks to the heal and the plus two special defense, Solgaleo can take another one of those max quakes, and they've run out of max turns anyway, so their ground type move, whatever it is, will be doing less damage to my Solgaleo too. I get a yawn off into the Palkia, which is huge because it will fall asleep at the end of the next turn, and then Togekiss goes down, which isn't too bad because it means I can bring in my Rillaboom and I now have fake out pressure. Their last is Regieleki, and that's the reason why I didn't bring my other restricted in Kyogre, because it just matched up so poorly against Palkia and Regieleki. So here I can go for a fake out into the Regieleki and a Sunsteel Strike into the same Regieleki. Despite it being resisted, I didn't have much to hit it more powerfully. I've got Wild Charge in the set, so it wouldn't have done too much. But yeah, it did a decent amount, and I know that next turn the Aurora Veil will wear off and I can go for a Grassy Glide into the Regieleki, so it won't get a chance to attack next turn. And at the end of this turn, the Palkia is going to fall asleep because of the yawn, so that is really, really great positioning for me. It's all looking pretty rosy, and at this point my opponent decides to forfeit. So that's pretty great, and I think that this battle really nicely showed the potential for Healing Wish in doubles. If you pair it up with Ally Switch, you can get a full heal on a Dynamax Pokemon, which is massive. So I think that this change to Healing Wish was probably so that you could use it in such a way in doubles battles to try and get those Dynamax heals. I still don't think we've seen the true potential of Healing Wish, and I'm really excited to hear if any of you guys have come up with some interesting combos to get Healing Wish to its max potential. Let me know in the comment section if you think that there are any other really underrated moves. I'd be really interested to hear that. But that's going to be all for today. I've been Fu, you've been awesome, and hopefully see you next time. Goodbye!